1999. He began life as a farmer, made a failure, and then took up the profession of law, in which for a time he achieved only moderate success. His rare gifts as an orator, however, attracted attention, and in 1765, he was elected a member of the Virginia Legislature, or House of Burgesses, as it was then called. He astonished Paul by his powerful eloquence in opposing the Stamp Act, and he was among the foremost in defying the tyrannical steps of King George III and his Parliament. It was on March the 23rd, 1775, that losing patience with the timidity of his associates, he swept the Second Revolutionary Convention of Virginia off its feet by his magnificent oratory. The historical "Give me liberty or give me death" speech was delivered in the old church in Richmond, and among the auditors who were held spellbound by the impassioned appeal was young Thomas Jefferson, who often referred to it with admiration in after years. In vain, after these things, may we indulge the fond hope of peace and reconciliation. There is no longer any room for hope. If we wish to be free, we must fight. I repeat it, sir, we must fight. An appeal to arms and to the god of battle is all that is left us. They tell us, sir, that we are weak, unable to cope with so formidable an adversary. But when shall we be stronger? Will it be the next week or the next year? Will it be when we are totally disarmed? And when a British guard shall be stationed in every house, shall we gather strength by irresolution and inaction? Shall we acquire the means of effectual resistance by lying supinely on our backs and hugging the delusive phantom of hope until our enemies shall have bound us hand and foot? We are not weak if we make a proper use of those means which the God of nature has placed in our power. 3 millions of people armed in the holy cause of liberty.